Hello. In 2016, I built the world's largest Rubik's Cube by extending a mass-produced 18 cm cube with plastic pipe and cardboard boxes. My cube had an edge of 1.57 metres and Guinness declared an official world record. In mid-2018, that record was beaten by Wes Nelson. I immediately thought about regaining the record, but was reluctant to commit so much time and money. After all, my previous cube barely worked, so a bigger one may not function at all. I had some ideas about how to improve the mechanism, but they were untested, so it would still be a gamble. A way round this problem was to make a giant 2x2 at an equivalent scale as a test. It would also regain my unofficial 2x2 record, which Red KB broke. It would be a kind of dual project, and most of the parts could be used for the giant 2x2 and also a 3x3 later. Obviously there would be divergence at some point as I near completion of the 2x2. So as before, I used an 18 cm cube with hand cast resin joins for the pipes and boxes. You can see here how fragile the core is and how I added parts to the corners and edges to make them stronger and less likely to pop. On my previous big 3x3, I also strengthened the core itself with milliput and bigger screws. With my new project though, I'm replacing the core with a solid metal cube and much larger machine screws. So this is a final modified core design. That obviously goes over there. I have a washer there, these super heavy duty springs, another couple of washers, and then a couple of nuts go on the top. So the edge and corner cubies are pretty much the same as before, with the same sort of modification. Here I am casting adjoining pieces and strengthening parts. I only need corner joins for the 2x2, but as I stated earlier, I'm working towards both a 2x2 and 3x3 at this stage. The moulds are made from silicon rubber, and I am casting in polyurethane resin. This is exactly the same as in my world record 3x3 construction video. So this is a partly assembled, modified central 3x3, which I will use in a giant 3x3 should I make one. I haven't added the centre caps since I just want to test that it moves okay. Now I know that it does, I will swap the edges with regular ones since I don't need the edge joins on a 2x2. And here it is, ready for the 2x2. It does however need bandaging, or the middle layer will go out of alignment causing lockups. And the arrival of the cardboard boxes. These are sold as 70 cm cubed, but that's the internal size and means because of the flaps they are not perfect cubes externally. That caused me loads of problems later. Here I am gluing down the flaps to make the boxes as strong as possible. I need need to cut away some of this corner to make way for the 18cm cube. Small cardboard boxes are glued and fastened into the corner that's been cut away. The same arc is also cut from their corner, and a length of plastic pipe runs from the large cube's outer corner through the small box and into the plastic 18cm cube and the expanding foam. I ordered enough materials for the giant 2x2, but I will need a lot more if I decide to make a giant 3x3. As before, the rigid foam gives further strength to the cubies and makes it possible to round the edges by bashing them. Another test. You can see how I have cut holes in each cubie so I can adjust the pipes inside. This will remain possible almost until the end. Now the bashing. Bizarrely, I found this is a really effective way to get the rounded edges. It looks pretty awful at this stage, but once covered in thick gaffer tape, it's surprisingly effective. So at this stage, I was pretty confident. I felt my experience gained from making the world record 3x3 meant this would be straightforward and easy. I was possibly too confident though, since I had made a big error. The internal size of each box is 70cm cubed, which means the external size is obviously bigger. When I was gluing the flaps, I measured this as 72cm and made sure it was the same in both directions of the side I was working on. However, for some reason I never checked the third dimension and had assumed it was the same like they were on my giant 3x3 cubies. During this assembly, I realised the boxes were not lining up correctly and discovered that third dimension was up to 74cm. This meant the whole thing was utterly useless and my time and effort had probably been wasted. I had a break from the project for a few days, but then thought about ways to rescue it. The only solution I could think of was to literally bash those two unwanted centimetres out of each cubie. This caused much of the expanding foam to fall away and created ugly creases in the cubies. Some could be disguised with tape again, but the overall quality sunk very low. I never bothered to film this frantic attempt to rescue the project. Yes, it worked, but I knew these battered and bashed cubies could never be used for a 3x3. So finally I was back on track. Since the giant 3x3 now seemed very unlikely, I decided to incorporate a little joke I had been planning for it. I thought it would be fun to reveal the completed puzzle by climbing out of a cubie. This meant I had to modify the inside of one cubie and make a door that I could fit through. I used coloured 1mm thick high impact polystyrene sheet for the 60cm stickers. I can easily get the four squares required from one of these giant sheets. Last time I used white plastic and covered it with coloured vinyl and then clear protective plastic. This newer method is far less time consuming and the stickers are actually more durable. Fixing them on with double-sided tape means they can be removed and reused if required. So finally it was completed and I was ready to make my first video. Remember that the boxes have already been weakened and climbing in and out puts further stress on them. Any plans to reuse them on a 3x3 had long since gone. I want to do as much as I can with a 2x2 before breaking it up, and at time of upload I still have a couple of plans for it. Amazingly it still works, so hopefully I'll have one or two new videos featuring my ideas in the coming weeks or months. I don't know if I will ever attempt the 3x3 record again. I still have many parts I can reuse from this project, though I'll certainly need new boxes. If I do attempt it, it won't be for a while.